Well, winter isn't even over yet, and Australians are already being warned to prepare for one of the most significant bushfire seasons in history. Most of Queensland, New South Wales and the Northern Territory put on notice. For more, let's bring in QFES Commissioner Greg Leach in Brisbane and RFS Inspector Ben Shepherd in Sydney. Good morning, guys. Ben, long time no see. I was doing a bushfire course, a media bushfire course with you yesterday, and you were running through the risks for this upcoming season. I think it's really important to prepare everyone out there. What would you say to our viewers?
Yeah, look, very much so. The preparation is a shared responsibility. As we've probably heard over the recent weeks and months, we haven't had those opportunities through autumn and winter to do a whole heap of hazard reduction. As we move closer to summer now, we're going to look on everybody to play their part. We are looking at a big swathe of New South Wales that is potentially going to be at risk this season, and primarily that's after three incredibly wet years. We're seeing some incredible grass growth stretching up through places like the Hunter and out through the western parts of the state. But equally as well, there's a lot of places that didn't burn through that awful 2019-20 fire season that could prove problematic this year. As we move into a drier period, a possible El Nino. So we're looking for people to play their part and prepare for the upcoming season.
I think it's forefront of people's minds after seeing what happened in Maui and through Greece and other parts of Europe and Canada and the US. Greg, what's your message? I mean, you've, I guess, got a bit on your plate this morning with that house fire in Brizzy, but what's your message to the rest of Queensland?
Yeah, similar to Ben's message. So yesterday, the Australasian Fire Authorities Council and the Bureau of Meteorology released their seasonal outlook for spring. And there'll be no surprises to many people living in regional and rural Queensland. We've had above average rainfall over the last three summers due to La Nina. But in the last 6 months, the weather conditions have changed. We're now on the cusp of potentially an El Nino declaration. The Bureau of Meteorology are monitoring that closely. We've got prolific grassland growth through parts of central and western Queensland. And over recent weeks, that grass has dried out. And we've seen some fires, particularly out on the Darling Downs area, with fire behaviour that you wouldn't normally expect to see this time of the year, which suggests that the grasses are drier and the soil moisture is less than what we've anticipated. So our message to people who are thinking about using fire to clean up around their property, you may have left your run too late. So before you do light up trying to clean up around your property, please make contact with your local rural fire service, talk to your local fire warden and just make sure whether conditions are right to be lighting up.
People in the regions tend to have a better idea about how these things run and how they're going to handle it. Ben, you mentioned this yesterday about grass fires too in our briefing. They move so quickly and people can, under pressure, make silly calls, stupid calls and catastrophic calls.
Yeah, look, what grass fires are probably underestimated a little bit when we compare to them bushfires, but they move three times quicker than a bushfire. So they can quickly cut roads, they can quickly impact on people and property. So we need them to understand that. But reiterating the message there from the Commissioner is if you are thinking about using fire on your property, you need to check the conditions. Over recent weeks, we've seen too many escaped private hazard reduction burns that have gone on to impact on property and people. So please check the conditions. Make sure that you've got the right permits in place and just be safe. Don't be the fire risk to your community. This could be potentially quite a long and protracted season and we just need people to play their part.
All right. Just Commissioner, before we go to just on that Brisbane fire, they did incredible work trying to reduce its spreading. Any update for us?
What you heard from Tim earlier is what I'm aware of at the moment. The fire was extinguished about an hour ago. They're now damping down and hopefully fire investigators can get in there a bit later this morning and see whether we can work out what the cause of that fire was. But good news that there's no injuries for the six people who were evacuated from those adjoining properties.
Amazing pictures. Good on you guys. Thank you so much. We'll talk to you soon. Hopefully not too soon. Thank you, Jane.